Hey, what's up guys? Today I'm gonna show you how to make a mouse dodging game in Scratch. So let's get started. So we are basically a cube. We can use the mouse cursor to move. And you have to just avoid the spikes coming from everywhere. Because if they touch you, you lose. You can also restart. Let's make this. So first of all, delete the cat sprite and make a new sprite. And name this player. Now make a cube. You can customize it the way you want. Okay, so we have the player. Let's make it go to the mouse pointer. So when the green flag clicked, forever, go to mouse pointer. Now you can see it is following the mouse pointer, but it is really sticking to it and it is really jittery. So to make this smooth, you can just basically remove this block and instead put go to X and Y block. Now in them, we'll put a different type of like algorithm. It is just really cool. So basically put a plus operator and in this you can just put X position block. Here you can put a divide operator and then put a minus operator. Now put X position block here, mouse X here and the amount of smoothness you want, which is 3 here. This is the block you need. Put it in X position. And for the Y, you can just duplicate this. And instead of X position and mouse X, you can use Y position and mouse Y. Just like this. And put it in Y input. As you can see, this works. You can adjust the smoothness by changing this value. The higher it is, the more smooth it will be. Just don't make it too high, like not more than 5. And also put some go to front layer and show. Now let's make the spike. So make a new sprite called spike. And let's make a triangle. So to make a triangle, you can just hold down shift and make a square like this. Now this is a perfect square. Now use this tool and delete this node. Click on it and hit delete. You can see this is a triangle. Now you can go back to select tool and just hold down shift and rotate it like this. Now it is pointing in the 90 degree direction or whatever you call it. Now you can hold shift and drag it down like this. Now this is looking like a spike. You can just snap it to the center and now you can customize it in the way you want. You can get this from the link in the description. Now let's code this. So first of all, when the green flag clicked, hide. And that is because we'll be spawning clones and not using the sprite itself. So to make clones, put a forever loop, create clone of myself and we'll put a delay, which will be of like maybe 5 seconds. Or if you are just confused like me, put pick random 3 to 7 seconds or whatever you want. So it will either go to 3, 4, 5, 6 or 7 seconds. Now when I start as a clone, go to front layer and show. So basically the clone will be visible. Now we need to make it go to the top, bottom, left or right. And from there, it will approach the player. So for it to spawn from the top, you can just put your go to X0, Y0 block, pick a random block inside of X and in the Y values, you can just put your negative 240 and 240. And in Y, you can put 180. This way it will spawn from anywhere on the top. Now for the bottom, you can duplicate this. Instead of Y180, put negative 180. Now for left or right, you can duplicate this. Now drag this pick random to Y. Put here negative 180 to 180. And in X, you can put 240. This is for the right. For left, you can duplicate this. Put it here and set X to negative 240. This is for top, bottom, left and right. Now to randomly choose between them, you can just put your nested if statement like if else, put a equal to operator, if else, pick a random 1 to 2 is equal to 1. So if it is 1, it will go here. And if it is 2, it will go here. Now we need to nest it because it has only 2 inputs. We want 4. So duplicate this and put it in if. Now duplicate this again and put it in else. Now we have 4 inputs. In the first one, put for top, second put for bottom, third put for right, and fourth put for left. Now you can just put it here. Just like this. Now once it is spawned, you need to approach the player. So first of all, you can put your like point towards player and repeat until put a or block here touching player or touching edge. So if it touches the player, the game will stop. And if it touches the edge, the score will increase. Now put move 15 steps. So it will point towards the player and move 15 steps. This is the speed basically. So I'll just put here 10 because 15 will be really fast. And after that, once it touches somewhere, you can just delete this clone. Now if we use this, it will just spawn here and it will be already touching the edge. So it will delete itself. To fix that, you can just put here like repeat until not touching edge, move 10 steps and put it above the repeat until block we just made, just like this. Now if you start the game, you can see the spike is coming and approaching me, but you can see only one spike is spawning at a time. And if you want multiple, you can just do it like go to spike and just put your repeat. You can put a pick random block here from 2 to 4 and put it here. Create clone of myself should be inside of the repeat loop. Now you can see multiple spikes are spawning at once. Now if the spike touches the player, we need to end the game. And also if it touches the edge, it should increase the score by 1. So for this, make a variable called score for all sprites. And here you can put a script like, first of all, remove this, delete this clone block. If touching edge, change score by 1 and put delete this loon below this. So now it will increase the score. Now go to player and when the green flag clicked, set score to 0. So it will always reset the score. Now we also need to stop the game when the spike touches the player. So to do that, you can just put your like, go to player, forever loop, if touching spike. So if it is touching the spike, it will basically broadcast end and then hide. So basically, this will broadcast a message that the game has ended. Now if you don't know, we are also making the restart menu just like this. When we lose, we click on restart and it will restart the game. So for that, we need to broadcast end. Now when we broadcast end, go to spike and make a script here like when I receive end, delete this clone. So when the game ends, if there are any spikes on the screen at that moment, they all will be deleted. Now make a new sprite called end screen or whatever you want. Now make a you lost screen just like this. Now make a restart button. Now once you have done this, duplicate this 2 times. In the first one, name it layout. In the second one, delete the restart button and name it background. And in the third one, delete you lose text and also the background and name this one restart button. Now you can just code it like when the green flag clicked, hide. When I receive end, go to front layer and show. Now this sprite will be the background and a clone will be the button. So go to front layer and show, switch to costume, background. Create clone of myself. Now it will create a clone, which will be our restart button. When I start as a clone, go to front layer, show and switch to costume, restart button. Now we'll make it clickable. So forever, if else, touching the mouse pointer, maybe add an effect like set brightness effect -20 and in else set brightness effect to 0. Now if mouse down, wait until not mouse down. Then if touching mouse pointer, this will basically detect a click. Whatever we put here will happen when we click on the button. Now we'll just broadcast restart and also delete this clone. Now when I receive restart, first of all hide and then we need to reset the values. So go to player, when I receive restart, just go to front layer, show, set score to 0 and also now make a new variable called spawn spikes for all sprites. So if the spawn spikes variable is 1, the spikes will spawn, like they will actually keep coming. But if the variable is 0, they will stop. This will avoid any spikes coming to the player when we have actually lost the game. So to do that, if put an equal to operator, spawn spikes is equal to 1, put this create clone of myself inside of this and put this in the repeat loop. And now we also need to set the spawn spikes variable to 1. Go to this sprite. When I receive end, just set spawn spikes to 0. Also go to player, set it here like set spawn spikes to 1. Now you can see when I start the game, the spikes are approaching me. Now the score is increasing. That is working perfectly fine. When we lose, spawn spike variable is 0. You will not see any spikes coming towards us when we are lost, just like this. And when you click on restart, the menu disappears. The score is back to 0 and the spikes will start approaching us just like this. Now this is working perfectly fine. Now that's it for this video. You can get all the assets from the link in the description. And if you have any doubts, you can comment. Thank you guys for watching and I'll see you in the next video.